another story, a story of Nama's glory. It concerns a couple, a German couple, who lived near the ashram for 17 to 18 years, devoted to Bhagwan Sri Yogi Ram Sarath Kumar and their master, Mr. Lee. Fokker and Wute. They had gone to Germany for a holiday from Tiruvannamalai for his annual vacation. In Germany, he with his wife and two children were traveling by car when they ran into a heavy traffic jam. Fokker became very angry at the delay and decided to try a diversion route. But alas, there was also a traffic jam which delayed them by more than an hour, which of course it irritated everyone. Finally, they somehow reached the 6-lane highway where Fokker chose to drive in the second fastest lane. They were speeding ahead, vehicles on either side. Fokker was traveling at about 150 kilometers per hour. In Germany, there is no speed limit on the highways. Suddenly, Fokker and Wute saw a small car from the left lane, that is from the first lane, heading into their lane, that is the second lane. Just ahead of them, a large car on the right was also trying to enter into their lane at the same time. Fokker and his wife Wute, to their horror, saw the cars on either side speeding up towards a collision course just ahead of them. And they screamed, Yogi Ram Sarath Kumar, at the top of their voices as the cars crashed. About 200 feet away, because of the collision and the high speed with which the cars had run, they spun off in opposite directions at dizzying speeds, making another truck which was coming that way go zigzag. And the truck in turn unsettled many of the other vehicles. So you can see, you can imagine the confusion that was created and the cars moving as they liked. They seemed to have a mind of their own, uncontrolled by anybody. In the meantime, the lane ahead of Fokker was clear for a while, and so Fokker's car shot through, and he halted his car a little ahead and ran back to see what damage had been done due to the accident. There were two women traveling in the small car whose engine had been crushed. The car was a wreck, but the two women were miraculously unhurt and were sitting dazed in the wrecked car. Fokker offered to send his wife Wute, who is a qualified nurse, to attend on them. Meanwhile, another lady in a car who stopped behind them had come there. She said that she was a doctor and could handle the situation herself. So there were miraculously no injuries at all to the occupants of the other car which had collided with the small car. So it was all hell let loose, and yet the damage happened only to the vehicles and not to the people. What a wonder. It became the talk of the town that, of course, nobody knew that Mr. Fokker and his wife Wute screamed Yogi Ram Sarath Kumar, and it was Yogi Ram Sarath Kumar who adjusted the whole lot in such a way that whatever was meant to happen to people around got shifted to the vehicles. You see, the glory of the name that they screamed just in time, though they could not help the situation, they did help by screaming Yogi Ram Sarath Kumar, which saved every life around, despite all the confusion that was caused. So, dear devotees of Bhagwan, let us remember once again the glory of the name and what it can do. And chant more and more and more and keep offering them at his lotus feet. And pray. Pray with intensity, wholeheartedly. Beloved Bhagwan, here is another story of Nama's glory. One lady from Madurai by name Meenalakshmi had been suffering from severe pain in the ear for 13 years. Not just 1 year or 2 years, 13 years. Many, many doctors and many treatments, but all in vain. If anything, now the pain has become more acute than ever before. What was more, the pain in the ear was constantly accompanied by severe headache as well, making it intolerable. When she approached the doctor, he said, "Oh, it has been there for so long and now has intensified. There could be something wrong with your brain. Let us have a CT scan done and then start the treatment." Now that was a shock to the whole family. Needless to say how agonized they were. At this time, that was nearly 5 years back, by Providence, Meenalakshmi and family came to Thiruvannamalai on their way back to Madurai from some place. As Meenalakshmi did not know anything about Bhagwan Yogi Ram Sarath Kumar at that time, she went straight to Arunachaleshwar Mandir. There, in a mandap, she saw the photos of the great masters, Sri Seshadri Swami, Sri Ramana Bhagwan, and Yogi Ram Sarath Kumar Bhagwan, and a few others. Her sister told her to look at those great masters' eyes intensely. Then she would be able to feel their divinity. Somehow, Meenalakshmi was drawn to Yogi Ram Sarath Kumar's picture. She began to gaze at the eyes of Bhagwan intensely. Few minutes passed. Suddenly, she felt Bhagwan from the picture entering straight into her. She felt ecstatic. And with that experience, extraordinary experience, she returned to Madurai. There, she came to know more and more about Yogi Ram Sarath Kumar and his glorious Nama. With great joy and enthusiasm, she began to repeat his name. One day, a friend by name Meena Ramanathan invited Meenalakshmi to come home for a Nama Bhajan session by Sri Masanamuthu. Very happily, Meenalakshmi hastened to attend. While the Nama was going on, Meenalakshmi, despite her great agony of pain in the ear and head, began to repeat the name with joy and tears. Tears of agony and joy of the name. Suddenly, she had something like a vision. Bhagwan came down from the photograph, sat near her, put his finger into her ear and drew something very black from that and then threw it out. The vision disappeared and she felt a thrill in her body and became ecstatic. What was more, there was no more pain in the ear and the head. She thought it was a temporary relief. But for the past 5 years, the pain had not returned at all, proving that it was no vision but true experience, a divine gift of his glorious name. So, dear friends of Bhagwan, let us all chant more and more of this wonderful divine name and pray intensely, beloved Bhagwan,